Hey everyone, it's Joan Azaz here from the Automator. And when I first started learning programming, I was really, really surprised at how often parsing text came up. And if you play with the basic stuff, stir split and things like that in AutoHotkey or whatever language you're using, it only takes you so far because data is messy. And that's one thing I learned in data science stuff is like, man, data is really, really messy. So once you learn about regular expressions, there's no going back because it solves. Like if it didn't exist, we'd have to create it because it solves so many things, and they're also optimized. They run at lightning fast speeds. It's crazy powerful. So we just launched this new course. Here we're going to show you a couple of just examples to help give you the concepts of how regular expression. How would you match this if you weren't using a regular expression? So, like,
Right.
you got some phone numbers here.
Right. There we go. So we have a few phone numbers, and as you just mentioned, your data is really messy. So you might get the phone numbers like this. You might get it like this, or you know what? You might get it like that, or they might include the country code or
And more
whatever.
importantly, anything you get right now isn't the entire universe, right?
Right.
You can't predict. So that's why you have to really think about what do I see in my data, but also what might happen, right?
Right.
So that's the one is like you build even with RegEx, you build to here, but you have to think about what's not there. And regular expressions allow you to solve for maybe there's gonna be multiple spaces in here. Maybe there's gonna be 12 instead
Right.
of two, right? And it helps with all that stuff.
One of the issues that we have, like if you use like a string split function that allows you to kind of like grab some text and split it into chunks based on a specific character, you might realize, hey, I cannot split on the dashes because this one doesn't have a dash, right? So I cannot split there. Now you have to split on the space or the dash. Yeah, what happens when you don't have spaces? You see, so you
Oh,
have so many weird situations going on,
put it up
right?
top. Put it up top and just show them to highlight it. So put your space in your search.
Okay, so in here, if I make a space, yeah, there are the spaces, right?
But they didn't
And
roll that.
if,
Yeah.
right. And now if I have the dashes, there they are. So what regular expressions allow you to do, and this is the way how I usually think about it, is that you are looking for patterns. And that's exactly what the regular expression means. It's an expression of something that happens over and over, which is regular, and it's just a pattern. So instead of thinking about splitting the text as is, I can refer to something as a concept. Let's talk about the concept of a digit. Well, if I use this, I could capture every single digit in this here because I'm capturing a concept. And if I say capture three digits, I can do that. And now a phone number usually is three digits, then three digits again. And then four digits. That's more or less the basic concept of a phone number right here. But now there are a few other things that I have to keep in mind. Well, how about dashes? I could have some dashes in here, but how about if those dashes are optional? Sometimes I have them, sometimes I don't. Now notice how these three got highlighted. What about instead of a dash, I have a space? So let's have a space or a dash here. Now, let me see. We could have here space or a dash. Oh, I'm missing the
Optional.
parentheses. That's why it's not matching. So
Well,
sometimes
this
we
is
can have
where,
some parentheses around, right? So let me have these parentheses. Let's make them optional. So they are optional as well because sometimes I have them, sometimes I don't. There you go. So now you see that I'm matching almost all the phone numbers in here, right? Now, once you look at some regular expressions, it looks really cryptic. It's like, what the hell are you doing here? And that's what we're going to do on the course. We're going to go slowly building up to a point where you would look at this and you will not see it as complex as it might look like right now. Later on, you will be able to grab a section, say, hey, this thing might be optional, and once you look at it, you will understand why I put that section in there and why it started matching up here. So this is part of how you see how easy I wrote that because I understand more or less what is going on. That's what we want you to do. We want you to look at the numbers and realize, hey, I know that I cannot split on this, but there is a pattern to it. How can I translate that pattern into something that would allow me to split the text into multiple chunks, however I need them? Is the same with email apps?
Yeah, let's not go keep going. I mean, I think they get the idea about the pattern matching stuff. So our course, and it's over 4 hours, right, Isaias? And here's the other really important part. You told me the other day, how many videos do you recall are in it?
73 videos, right?
Yeah, so they're all, what's great is they're bite-sized, they're broken down into learning a given concept one at a time with examples on how to work through the stuff. You want to bring up the page real quick? Show people where, if they want to learn more about the course, we have, you know, of course, the just talking about what's in it. And then we have a syllabus on the what's covered in the course. And this is one of those things, RegEx, it's also a use it or lose it type of thing. You got to kind of keep up on it a bit, but it's crazy, crazy powerful. And I know a lot of people who would like work in IT and programming, and they don't even understand regular expressions even exist. Yeah, they're like, it's really not that hard to get started. But there are, it's a whole language on its own, right? Like it's very, very, very robust. We don't go too deep crazily, but we teach a lot of the different concepts and different patterns.
All the basics, actually all the basics from the very basics that all of in that few seconds that we displayed a few minutes ago, right? I actually used almost all of them. And the same with, you know, so we go over all the basics. And once you watch the course, whatever we just did, it will look easy because then you will understand because I explained every single one of the things that you just saw.
Can you go back to the RegEx 101, by the way, which that's the site we use in the a lot of the training, right? To show how to
publish
stuff out. But one that may, oh, you already deleted it. Oh, well. I was going to say was the grabbing of, okay. If you wanted to rearrange this, right? That's one thing that you, identifying the patterns, one thing, but then to understand that, oh, if I actually wanted, let's say you were doing something with month, day, and year, and I want them different orders, right? It's so easy once you get groups, and of course you can also name your groups, but to move the things around, it's another great example of you're doing both pattern matching and text manipulation, you know, in one.
That's right, because we talk about, and you will see it in the course in here, about grouping. And once you group something as you're matching it, right, you're kind of like separating it into chunks that then you can do whatever you want with them. Delete this chunk, move it around, and do whatever you want. So we also cover that type of concepts in the course as well.
Yeah, so check it out. If you're interested in saving 25%, our hero program, you can easily join that. And then, or now we have a subscription where you can just sign up and have access to all of our courses for a monthly fee. So let us know what you think. Please like the video if you learned something and check it out. Cheers.
Bye.